The concern for us here in the Pacific Islands is the global warming, and that contributes to the high-rise sea level. And most of our people on the islands, they rely on the sea for their food and for what they can get to help them also earn a little money. And at this time, we are being challenged and we are being threatened by the high-rise sea level that we are experiencing. And many of our islands now are beginning to see that good parts of the islands, of the land on the islands, have been washed away. And when it is happening like this, islands are getting smaller and smaller. And we have examples of islands like this, many islands like this. Now, scientists are predicting that by year 2050, many of the islands will be gone. And this really makes it very risky for us to be able to keep our islands free and safe from water eroding parts of the islands away, and also that the islands are getting smaller and smaller. On the other hand, you know, people are experiencing that the food crops are being affected so much by the high-rise sea level. And even the coconut trees and the sago palms growing for food, these are drying up because of the high-rise sea level is affecting it, coming up, and even affecting the roots and even where they will draw water and draw nutrition from the soil. That is no longer there because the sea has gone right up. And so we have one of our islands now is very badly affected, and that is Carteret's Island in Bougainville. The island is experiencing food shortage and also for water. They cannot get water from under the ground where they usually dig well to draw water. That water now is not fit to drink. So what they do now, they rely much on coconut, and for food they rely on the sea, and that is fish and shellfish and all other food they can get from the sea. And they are far away from the mainland. And so this is where many of our islands will be like this in the future. But now I bring the new concern, that we are also kind of grappling with this time, the question about the seabed mining. It poses a great danger also to us. The problem is we have started already to experience the high-rise sea level affecting our islands, eroding good parts of the islands. And it will do worse. The sea, for us, the sea is like a supermarket. That's where you get your fish, and that's where it is preserved, and that's where the food are. And you know, you get what you just want to feed on for the day. And then tomorrow again, you go back and get it. So it's really a supermarket for our people, the sea. And this is really a big thing for us. So when this is taken away from them by the seabed mining, by the cutting down of the top of the rocks on the reefs, this is what it will happen. It will destroy the environment. It will destroy the home for the fish. And who knows, because studies have not been conducted. We have not been advised and made aware. And it is earmarked to be done on Kavieng, on New Island. And that is this Solowara 1. That's where the project will be. And it will begin there, and that's where they will start to experiment this new technology, the deep sea mining, with that new technology that they have developed and to be tested here. But to test it, the government has not done its job to get experts like biologists and so on to do their studies on marine life and also the negative impact on this. One of the big things also, when they take the rocks and bring it up to the main ship, and then to separate the rocks from the minerals that they want to get, they will use certain chemicals. Now, where will they store these chemicals? Where will they make sure that this chemical is not just dumped into the sea? We can't presume that the sea is big and it will absorb this. And this is a grave concern for us here. Now, the church has been doing something, the Catholic Church, plus all churches together, PNG Council of Churches, we work together to come out and come out in public and make known our concern for the effects on this seabed mining, and especially on the livelihood of the people, how it will affect them. And at the end, I'm saying always that once the sea is taken away from them, you know, what they live on in the sea is taken away from them, and the environment that is there to make sure that the food is there for them, the fish and all that is there. One that is taken away from them, they will be much poorer than before. And you know, we come from a place where we don't have that economy to back us up. We don't have money. People coming from the island people, we have no money to be able to help us begin a new life, nothing. And so when this is taken away from us, that's it. We are in a situation where we'll be in difficulties for our life. And so for me, this is a great concern I'm voicing and I am sharing. Now, I have here a representative from the PNG Council of Churches, one of the officers. We did make an awareness and we came out and we did talk about the negative impact that the seabed mining will have on us. Because our concern is we are not getting enough information or no information on how this will affect us. And not only us, but also the marine life. Most of the marine life will be terminated because we do not know how many species are there. And that is also a grave concern for us. And so the church have done something, the Catholic Church have done something, a bishop's conference, and also now also the PNG Council of Churches, we are working together and we have been doing a lot of awareness on this. So now we'll be talking about climate change refugees. Now, for those who are leaving their land and going to a new land, finding place to live and becoming refugees because of the disappearance of the island, it is not because they're leaving the island because of fighting. Of course, there's danger for their life also, because, but the real reason is that they're leaving the island because they have no more island, no more homes. Their homes will be taken, will be disappeared. It is disappearing. So they will have no more homes. So that's why the term refugees is really fitting for them, because now they will have no more homes. Now, some places are talking about climate change and they are saying climate change will come in the future. For us, no, it has arrived. It is affecting us. It's here with us now. We have to face the challenge of zeroing down the effect of a gas emission into the atmosphere. That is, and really the effect, we are facing it already. And even in the Iceland, the ice are melting. And the scientists are saying that it is melting faster than what they had predicted. And so this is where we are at this time. And this is our situation here in the Pacific and in Papua New Guinea. Thank you for listening.